Hey everyone, Derek Johnson with Tatango.com. A few weeks ago, we launched a brand new product here at Tatango, which helps businesses reduce the risks of TCPA violations. So I wanted to do a quick video to demonstrate how this product works. And I made some kind of cue cards to help me out. So if you're running a text message marketing campaign, you know that most software providers will automatically unsubscribe a consumer when they respond back to a text message with the words stop, cancel. These are all because they're required by the CTIA, which is kind of a governing body of text message marketing. Unsubscribe or quit. So very, very specific words that if a text message contains those words, most software providers will automatically unsubscribe that person from receiving future text messages. Because if for some reason someone texted quit or unsubscribe and they continue to receive text messages, the consumer can sue that business that is sending the text messages for anywhere from $500 to $1,500 per text message because it's essentially text message spam. I asked for it to stop, therefore any future text messages would be considered text message spam under the TCPA. And the TCPA is federal law. The CTIA, that's kind of more like guidelines. So these are the guidelines, and the TCPA says essentially you can't spam people. So when they work together, it makes a lot of sense. Now, what we found here at Tatango by analyzing millions of responses to mass text messages is a lot of consumers, sometimes depending on the list, over 50% of consumers, when they want to opt out of a text messaging campaign, instead of texting these words, which really are not designed by the consumer, they're designed by this organization called the CTIA, and most consumers have no clue what that organization is, have never seen the handbook. Most consumers in some lists, some were over 50%, responded with things that feel more natural. So what would these things be? Things like, delete me from this list. That makes a lot more sense than just replying stop. So delete me from this list. And these are all ones that we've found when analyzing all of these responses. Do not send me any more text messages, please. Do not contact me again, thanks. These are natural language responses. Essentially asking to be opted out instead of replying stop and quit, unsubscribe, things that software can understand really easily. I'm done. Take me off this list. Thanks. And these are pretty, some are pretty complex, kind of like this one. It's saying, you know, kindly do not text, email only. Leave me alone. Thanks. Stop sending these messages. Will you please remove this number? And because it's natural language, they're using things like NO instead of spelling out number, or they're putting the hash a sign there. Also, this is a great one, and this is the last one. And these ones that I've shown you, these are examples, but there's thousands of different ways that consumers have texted in, essentially requesting that they've been opted out. And most software providers are not opting them out because they're not following the rules, the CTIA rules. They're not texting in stop and quit, unsubscribe. They're texting in natural language. And because the TCPA is so vague, especially right now, that can be considered, one of these can be considered a revocation of consent. Essentially, they're asking to opt out, therefore the business should opt them out. But if the software isn't smart enough, they can't opt them out. This is the last one. This one's kind of interesting. And this was only a fraction of the way people misspell the word unsubscribe. So even really if they misspell the word unsubscribe, that, you know, is still a revocation of consent and they should be removed from receiving future text messages. Now, some people have very, very bad spelling. as you can see here, if one of these people texted in, let's see, UNSUBSIDIZE, That's their version of unsubscribe, but you get the concept. They're trying to unsubscribe. And the business continues to send them text messages. Well, each one of those text messages could be a TCPA violation. And TCPA violation, as I said before, is anywhere from $500 to $1,500 per text message. So if this person texts this in, the software doesn't catch it, doesn't unsubscribe them, and then they continue to receive text messages day after day, week after week, even year after year, each one of those text messages is a violation. And the consumer can sue the company for anywhere from $500 to $1,500 per text message. So what does our new product do here at Tatango? It essentially, we've analyzed millions of text message responses, and we built a natural language processing tool that essentially goes through and automatically looks for things like this, looks for things like this and this, and it gets smarter. Every single response that comes through Tatango, the Tatango system is learning. So right now, we are going through all the text messages that are coming into our system. Now, these ones are the easy ones. Quit and unsubscribe, cancel. These ones are easy. These ones have been done for years. Most software providers will offer this as just kind of the basics. But with natural language processing and artificial intelligence eventually and kind of the whole how things are going, we're going to be able to really look at the sentiment and what actually the consumer is trying to tell you as a business, whether they want to stay in the campaign, whether they have a question, or whether they want to unsubscribe. So with this new product, when you receive a text message from your customers, and let's say it says this, or any version of unsubscribe, and again, these are just a few of the versions that we found, Tatango will automatically unsubscribe those consumers so they don't receive future text messages. Now, and I say unsubscribe automatically because that's really important. If you have a million or 5 million subscribers and you send a mass text message, there's going to be a lot of replies. You don't want to have to go through each one of those replies and manually unsubscribe people. That's why Tatango software looks for these things and then unsubscribes them. So that's Tatango's new product. I want to do a video. We did a press release a couple weeks ago. I want to do a video to kind of illustrate what it looks like with these cards. Hopefully it helps. And if you have any questions, please send us a note. You can always email sales@tatango.com. Again, my name is Derek Johnson, and I'm with tatango.com. Thanks.